Castillo, and we're here at the Democratic headquarters, and I'm sitting with George Latimer. Welcome.
Nice to be with you.
You're running for county executive, and I would like to ask you, what do you think Mount Vernon's greatest need is, and how can you help?
Well, I think the most important thing that Mount Vernon needs is a strong economic base, because without the money that comes from a thriving business community and a strong residential community, then the city doesn't have the resources it needs to improve itself. You have parks that you need for recreation, for kids. You have roads that have to be fixed and rebuilt. There's a need for housing in the community, and all of those things come out of having dollars and cents, resources to do it. I think the county has to be a better partner to Mount Vernon, not just look from afar, but to be in there, in the trenches, with the city. And both the city and the county have to engage the state in those efforts. We're not going to get that help from Washington under Donald Trump. He's not interested in doing these kinds of things in the urban setting. So it's going to come from us, those of us in the city, those of us in the county, and you need a county executive who not only was born in Mount Vernon, as I have been, but also one that has Mount Vernon in its heart. I grew up on the south side. I understand the urban problems that we've had, and I understand exactly how much money and energy it's going to take to solve those problems.
Welcome back. This is Aleida Castillo, and we're still here at the Democratic headquarters, and now I'm sitting with Marcus Griffith. How are you?
Good to see you. I'm excellent. Good to see you.
Thank you for taking the time to answer my questions. Marcus Griffith is city council for the city of Mount Vernon, and you were also president of the city council at some point. And particularly for you, I wanted to ask you, because you've been there a minute, and you have been the president, so you are in the trenches of knowing, what is city council as a group supposed to be doing, and what is the city council member as an individual supposed to be doing? Because I think that people need to know, right?
So the council is really the lawmakers of the city. We review what's going on in the city and set the tone for the city, set the laws. Whether it be, what time garbage trucks pick up garbage to what days the street cleaning is being done, we set the laws. Tree ordinances, any type of ordinances are the laws in the city. We also set the budget for the year, which sets the tone for the administration. So we do that at the end of the year for the next year. And that's basically what the council too. We have a role in setting the zoning for the entire city as well. So when people talk about what zone, what's a residential, what commercial, we set that as well. So that's really the council's responsibility. The one thing people don't understand is that city council people don't work in City Hall on a day-to-day basis. We're as close to the citizens as possible. We all have our full-time jobs, and we come to the council and review. We're really like the board of directors for the city. So the mayor and his administration handles the day-to-day activities. The controller sets the financial tone for the city and handles all of the payments and that sort of thing. But the city council sets the laws and really develops the city in that regard. A lot of people think city council are there every day, and that's what pays our bills. It does not. We're as close to the citizens as possible.